Hey, so growing up was a little bit different for me. I was in an area that had a lot of history, a lot of family, a lot of roots, 5 generations, in fact. And I was the actual 5th generation in this house. And I want to tell you a back-end story about this. You see, I got to Long Island through a great-great-uncle, through my great, I think it was a great-great-great-uncle. I kind of lose track because there's so many generations, so much history. And while I didn't care as a child, I want to share with you now because I thought it was actually, as I put this shirt on today, it made me think about this particular uncle who I never got to meet. And anyway, it was a house that he built. And it was in an area called Watermill. It was just outside of this other area called Sag Harbor. And the backstory was and it'll get to my, hopefully, draw you in about blubber, is he was a whaling captain. So what he did, now I don't know all the history. I wish, you know, and I may even do some investigating with that. But I do know, because we had some old whaling maps and I had been told some stories about whaling and whaling captains and what they did. My great-great-uncle was a whaling captain. And I don't know if you know anything about whaling, actually whaling, like hunting for whales. Now, I know that would be just criminal now these days, but the reality is way back in the 1800s, in the late 1800s, they hunted whales for oil, for blubber. And I was just doing a little research, just kind of on the side, not too long ago, and I was looking into how they did that and like how the ship sailed and they relied on the wind and what they did. And actually, not too long ago, we actually sold some maps that were starting to go bad. They were starting to rot. They sat in a whaling box. It was actually pretty neat. You think, oh, why'd you sell those? Because honestly, I didn't know what to do with them because they were going so bad. But they were actually legit whaling maps. Like there was areas of New England area that these whaling captains, my great-great-uncle, who used to track, right, on the ship. So here they were in the middle of the ocean. Right, hunting for whales for the blubber. And one of the cool things on the map, some of the records showed how many barrels of blubber they were able to get from, or I don't know, maybe I'm butchering as far as the terminology, but you get my drift, as far as they got the whales for the meat and then they got it for the blubber, the fuel. It provided source of fuel as well. So why am I even sharing that with you? Well, it definitely has something to do with maybe the blubber that's around your waist or your thighs or your hips or your body you're trying to get rid of. And, you know, I haven't used that word. We think of people when they're losing weight, fat, but we don't think of blubber, like blubber. That's kind of like a grotesque word you think of, but it was actually a very valuable source. It was something that my great-great-uncle used to hunt for. And what they would do is literally they'd be on these boats, these ships, right? And they had they literally had these like big spears. You think of like they would throw the spear in to the whale to kill the whale. And I can imagine how hard a job they worked. Like I can imagine how dangerous that kind of profession was to be out in the middle of the ocean. You kind of like think back, like it makes me think of like the Vikings, and you think of some of the old the shows you may watch that these guys are out in the ocean and the terrible conditions and the rough seas and perfect storm and all that kind of stuff. And they're throwing, you know, and then you got a whale that's attached when you harpoon a whale and you get it. Then you got to try to get it in. I don't even know how that looks. Like how, I don't even know what that looked like. How do you bring it into shore? How do you get all that blubber? So one of the things, you catch like so many barrels of it, 350 barrels or 20, well, however many they get from it. And I can't imagine the amount of work. I think it makes me think of today's world, kind of like today's world, the guys that are out, and it's way different because they have satellites and it's almost like the lazy man sport now with fishing, because you can track them and you can do this and that and you can hunt down the fish, and it's a bit easier than they used to have it. You know, they had to really like work hard, and I bet you it was physical work. That's the point. I bet you there was a lot of physical work. You see, back when my great-great-uncle was a whaling captain, chances are they could eat whatever they wanted, drink as much as they wanted, and not have to worry about putting on any weight. Now, mind you, they were younger, like maybe probably in their 20s and 30s. I don't think they were in their 40s doing that. But let's just say they're in their 20s and 30s, and they were out, they were working hard, very active, physically active, moving. They weren't probably sitting around too often, you know, watching Netflix and sipping Frappuccinos and stuff like that. So I say that is, how does that have to do with the blubber that's on my body right now? Well, you see, if you think about it in these terms, now I'm not saying that you should go out and hunt whales and that'll take the weight off. But if you can just think back to life how it used to be, and I'm not like back in the day kind of thing, you think of just the things that were maybe removed from their distractions of getting, they had to survive. So in other words, they had to move, they had to hunt, they had to find the whales because that was their source of income. They had to live off of that and prosper off of that because that was the only way. And I read stories about oftentimes these whaling captains would come to shore and they would not, they would be, you know, out in sea and they would not have any luck. Like a lot of, and what happened was the reason why whaling ended is because everybody tried to do it. Then what happened? Everybody became a whaling captain. Everybody went out there and then there was not any whales and then became endangered, right? And that's the story of today, why you don't see too many whales, partly why you don't see too many whales anymore. So back to how this relationship with you and the blubber that you have is to realize that, like, what if it was a survival? What if the extra 50 pounds of blubber, we're just going to use that term. It's not me fat shaming, so don't go there. So what if we were to use the term blubber? If you had 30 pounds of blubber on your body and, you know, think of the terms of the whale trying to get away from that. Can you imagine being a whaling captain out there? You think any of those guys probably had much blubber on them because all the hard work and intentionality they put into their jobs, right? A lot of jobs nowadays, look at my job. Now, I have to be intentional with the activity that I do and being really active. I have to make sure I work out and go to the gym or get active, go walk the dog, move, right? Keep moving, because in a world now, a lot of us, even more so now than ever, sedentary, we're sitting. Chances are those whaling captains didn't sit very much, right? And chances are they probably didn't have very much blubber. And chances are they probably ate regular, real food. They probably didn't have Oreo cookies on the ship. They probably didn't have Fruit Loops on the ship. They probably ate off of the boat. They probably had fresh food, real food. They might have even had some vegetables that they took. There isn't a rocket science to this, but the problem is we've gotten sold into believing there is. We've gotten in the soul in believing that if we only lose the weight, do some sort of a diet, do some sort of a quick fix, that is the solution. It's truly not the solution. You have to combine it. You have to be active. Maybe not like a whaling captain like my uncle, but you have to pursue an active, healthy lifestyle. You have to move. It's simple. You just have to move. Here's the thing. I don't know if you've ever heard the word skinny fat, right? Skinny fat. Skinny fat. There's just something to that where you meet somebody and like they never work out, but they're skinny. And, you know, you hate that person because they can fit in any clothes they want. But then they're out of shape. They're weak. They just happen to be thin, right? And it doesn't mean they're healthy. It just means they're thin. Thin and healthy is not, they're not synonymous with each other. Yes, synonymous. I think that's the word. That doesn't mean the same. So whatever kind of pursuit you're on, maybe you're that skinny fat person and you're realizing that, gosh, I may be skinny, but I'm getting older and I'm out of shape and I'm unhealthy and I ache and pains and hurt, things hurt. And I haven't done anything because I really haven't had to do anything. Or maybe that person that's more has that 20, 30, 40 pounds on of blubber and you're realizing, all right, like, well, why do whales have all that? Because they use it for fuel. Like whales just have their blubber for fuel. They go maybe a certain period of time without eating. But think of the size of them and needing that. And you think of like an animal like a bear maybe that hibernates, right? The reality is we've been hibernating. Like the problem is as we get older, our bodies kind of do more of a hibernation mode than when we were in our 20s and 30s and much more active. You know, people say, Mark, I don't know how I put this weight on. I still eat kind of the same. Like I still eat fairly healthy. I don't play sports anymore. I'm not nearly as active as I was. Well, there, ding, 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 ding. That's part of it, right? That's part of it is the reality is it all has to work together. And most people, a lot of times these days, think that it's just one way or the other. It's like, let's just do the diet and get the weight off. I don't need the exercise. All the diets out there say, don't worry about the workouts. We'll help you lose the weight. Cool. But as soon as you stop that diet, all the blubber comes back on, right? And I don't want that for you. And then the other side of the coin is the people who say, Well, just work out. We got workouts that can burn 1,000 calories a workout, and you can burn an extra 2 pounds of fat every week. You know, you don't have to worry about your diet. Just work out hard. Do two, three hours of cardio every day. You know, do this hour-long boot camp. We'll guarantee, we'll even put those monitors on and make sure you burn thousands of calories, and you won't have to worry about that. The problem is then you think it's an excuse to not eat healthy. And the problem with that is if you're not eating healthy, you're putting crappy fuel in your body, right? Crappy fuel. Chances are those men that were on the ships, they couldn't put crappy fuel. They didn't have access to the crappy fuel, crappy food. They had access to probably real food, fish. Maybe they fished for their food. They probably had to have the best sources of energy so they could do the hunting to get the whales, to get the blubber, so that can provide for their families, right, and the meat. So does that make sense? Anyway, I just wanted to bring you a cool old story from me. I was the fifth generation in a house. In fact, we have still some of the artifacts from my great uncle, and we have actually even whale tooth. We have actually some, and I think they're actually, it's actually, they're not that in danger, but you're not supposed to have them. But we had them in our families, we just didn't do anything with them. But I have that. It's pretty cool to think back in that and think back of how life used to be. And you think of like when gyms didn't exist and the word diet probably didn't used to exist. You ate food, you moved. And, you know, maybe some of those people also didn't live very long, because if they were on the ships and the ships went down, you know, chances are they had short lives. And maybe there is something to be said about having a short, healthy, fit life versus a long, like just terrible doctor's visits after doctor's visits and medication after medication. And hey, if you're going to live a long life nowadays, the average age for a male is 78 years old, maybe 80, 83, I think, for females. You all live longer. Is take the advantage now. If you're in your 40s and you're thinking to yourself, well, if I have a good 30, 40 years left, why not get my body in the kind of shape it needs? Why not get the blubber off? Why not move more? Why not eat healthier? That's my question to you. It is Labor Day weekend, right? And I was thinking of as Labor Day weekend. I was thinking of people that labor hard. And I had my family, my grandfather was a farmer. My dad was a farmer. And then he became a carpenter. He was not a builder, contractor. He wasn't like a new home builder and had everybody else do the work for him. He didn't sub out all the work. He did all the work. He banged the nails. He put up the roofs. He put up these shingles on my house. How about that? Not too bad, right? That's a master craftsman. My dad, you could call him a master craftsman. He was a true carpenter. He worked hard. And guess what? He hasn't battled with his weight his entire life. And now he rides his bike about 100 miles a week, and he's 70, almost 78 years old. How about that? There's something to be said about hard work. So listen, if you're going into this weekend, if you feel like you got that blubber sitting around your body and you're stuck, maybe you're stuck and you're struggling and you're thinking to myself, dang, there's a whole nother year that almost went by. And I know it's been distracting. I know it's been hard. And maybe you've had a lot of obstacles to get in the way. But the reality is life is going to continue to throw obstacles in your way. And you can continue to do one of two things. Now, if you're listening to me, if you have the extra blubber right now on you, 20, 30, 40 plus 50 plus pounds, you have a couple options, two options. You can keep making excuses, or you can start pursuing results. It's as easy as that. It's excuses or results. I don't know if you're tired of excuses. I know the people that reach out to me, the people they get on a call, one of the things they say is they don't say they're tired of excuses. They're just tired of trying. They're tired of being sick and tired. They're tired of all the things they've tried and failed on. They're tired of having gym members they didn't use. They're tired of believing that blubber, 20, 30, 40 pounds of blubber can come off and be sustainable off on a quick diet. Hey, listen, my wife works in GI, and I can tell you time and even more so now than ever. And I think I've heard it more in the last couple of years than ever. There's more and more people that are just waiting until they're 80, 90, 100 pounds overweight. And then they're just going to the doctor and saying, do I qualify for a lap band? Do I qualify for this? Do I qualify? Can I just tell you something on that respect? If you get to that point, like you really have a lot of blubber to the point where you don't know where else to go. And again, this is not my fat shame. It's just telling you reality. Because my wife works in GI. And guess what? She sees a lot of patients who one of two things. They're in trouble. Their guts are in trouble. Their bodies are in trouble. They're shutting down, being 80, 90, 100 pounds overweight. And they're shutting down. And then the quick fix, right? The quick fix is let's just have the surgery. Let's just put the band on. Let's just have gastric bypass. And here's the problem with that. Do you want to know how many more patients my wife has had after she's had a lot of patients that have come in after their bodies are worse after having those surgeries, worse. I've even had at least a dozen people that I've met, at least a dozen. I haven't worked with them all, but at least a dozen who've had that surgery, have had that lap band, who literally, like a whaling captain, like the doctors would do, is basically put in and take the blubber off, and it comes off quick, like a whaler would just literally cut that fat off, and it's almost what happens when it comes to gastric bypass. You lose the weight really, really quick. And then guess what? Nothing's changed. Your habits don't change. Your mindset doesn't change. And guess what? Your body does start to change, because guess what? The weight comes back on. And then you're like, I'm giving up, because it's worse off now that I had the surgery. And there's ways to get around it. It's kind of like, for a lack of better term, it's kind of like the Michael from The Office. I don't know if you ever watched The Office, but Michael from The Office, they share the story. He has a vasectomy, and then he has a reversal, and then he has another vasectomy, and then he has a reversal. It's like, that can happen just like that in the lap band and gastric bypass. You can have it removed. You can have it changed. You can learn how to adapt, and you can put the weight back on. And that, what I would hate, the reason why I'm bringing these things up as I talk to you about the story about blubber and whaling, is I would hate for you to have that weight come off and then you become, let's just say, so to speak, skinny fat, and realize that nothing else has to change. I have the weight down. I'm in the best shape ever. No, you're not. You're just less weight than you were before. It doesn't mean you're fit. It just means you're less weight. So you have the option to do that, or you have the option to not do anything. You have the option to keep going and churning and burning on the diets, or you have the last option, which is truly the best, is to get around a coach like me, who's been doing this 25 years, who understands the ins and outs of all the quick fix madness, craziness, understands you don't need long workouts, you don't need impossible diets, but there is a solution. And I know I don't have the only solution. I know I'm not the only coach, but I do know if you're the right fit, I will go to bat for you. I will get in your corner. I will stay with you by your side through the thick, through the thin, and get you so that you don't just lose weight, but you get in the best shape of your life. And if you're in your 40s and 50s and you have another 30, 40 years, why would you not want to be in the best shape of your life? There's a lot out there, a lot of enjoyment, a lot of things that you can do for fun, for your family, for your life, just to live it to the fullest. But if you're leaving it on the table, you're doing yourself a disservice. You're doing your family a disservice. You're doing your spouse a disservice. And I can tell you, it's so much more fun. I'm turning 48 in a couple weeks, and I'm very excited about it because I've been pursuing healthy habits. I'm not as fit as I probably could be, but I'm pursuing it. I'm probably not as healthy as some people are, but I'm still pursuing healthy. And you know what? The rewards are it's too many to count. So anyway, I hope this message found you well. It is Labor Day weekend, Labor Day weekend. If you've been laboring, so to speak, if you've been laboring with the blubber that's been sitting on your body, just send me a private message. Reach out. I'll send you a form. You just answer a couple questions. We'll get on a call. We'll see if we're a good fit. And if you and your spouse, I would just say this, if you've been listening this a long time, if you and your spouse both struggling, if you're feeling like, so to speak, whales, and you have that extra blubber on your body, and you know it's time to change, it's time, you're done with the churn and burn, you're done, you don't even want to think about the doctor's office. There's nothing attractive about wanting to go to a doctor and saying, I want bypass surgery, right? There's nothing that there's really, that's honestly, now I know for some that might be the only option, but if you're thinking like, that's going to be my main option, then you're leaving a lot on the table. So if you're that person, I have an incredible deal I'm doing this month for my birthday. My wife and I talked about it. I shared it in a video before. I'm not even announcing, only for those who are listening, my followers who are watching my videos, taking the time out of the day. I know that the chances are they're serious about it. They want real change. And you know what? I want to make it pretty much a no-brainer. If you and your spouse are a great fit, I'm making a no-brainer offer. I have actually had five to start with. I only have, well, actually after today, there may only be three spots available for couples. I can only take so many people onto my program. And if I have five couples, that's 10 people, and that's the max I can take in a month. So if you want to be the one of the last three, possibly four, chances are three couples to come into my world, to remove some of that blubber, learn the habits you need, and be around a coach who's going to go to bat and make sure that you succeed long-term, not just to lose the weight, long-term, to learn the habits you need to have a healthy and productive, happy, fulfilling life, reach out to me today. Take care. God bless. We'll see you soon.